Hello and welcome to this design practice module 6. In this particular module, I will be discussing about prototyping, how whatever you have ideated so far from building up an idea rack through the various observations as well as empathy mapping skills that you have formulated so far. So, in this particular module, we will be defining what is a prototype or what is prototyping. So, prototyping is about getting all the ideas and the explorations out of your head, okay, and into the physical world. So, that is how you define. That means, whatever you have planned and discussed and what kind of need statements you have built in the previous many steps, you are going to now complete that through or explore that little further by means of a physical form that you would like to build out of your ideas. So, a prototype can be anything that takes some kind of physical form. It could be a role playing activity, for example, it could be a space that you wanted to redesign, an object that you would like to use as a product, maybe an interface between a machine and a human being, or even a storyboard. I mean, a prototype can even be a storyboard. So, anything that achieves a physical form out of whatever has been ideating in your head so far is known as a prototype. But there is an immense use of formulating a prototype, because it gives you a sort of a concept map. It gives you an idea by just looking into a real life object rather than imagining into a imaginary space. So, here you could actually give form to your thinking, you could say, in terms of a prototyping. So, the resolution may be rough, it may be rapid, okay, of this particular prototype, does not matter, but it has to be have some form. That is the basic idea. And typically, prototype is something about making something people can experience, people can interact with, and their concept stage can get more refined by having a look at the prototype and playing around with the prototype. It may be not doing, or it may not be a complete functional prototype, it could just be simply a prototype related to the experience behind a product, but it has to be some kind of a physical entity. So, there are many different kind of prototypes which people do construct from time to time in product design activity. Some of them are being mentioned here. For example, there is a functional prototype. So, this is known as the CFP, or the critical functional prototype, which means really a prototype where whatever is the main idea or the theme has been constructed in toto with the functionality that is envisioned for the particular product. Now, if supposing if we were to construct, or if you were to just map the dental experience in our country, and then try to look at among the various things that the dentistry would need, what are the most important aspects or things where there could be a marked improvement in the dentistry. So, we have done some kind of a study, a design study in this respect, and found out that the dental chair is the most important component where a little bit of reduction in the price of the dental chair may improve the way that dentistry is done across the nation. So, once you have a sort of a bullseye view of what is the most important problem there, the question is about, can I make a functional prototype behind. So, the functional prototype in this case, for example, if we are looking at a dentist chair, is actually a chair which could be low cost. Okay. But apart from that, the more important part is about how to manage with your design thinking and your innovation in the area of dentistry to come up with this view that what is the most important area. And you could have something related to dentistry as a subject, as an experience prototype. For example, a very simple thing like a concave mirror, convex mirror, which could give you a map of what is inside your oral cavity, could be an experience that a person would have, which will enable him to think about going to the dentistry. Okay. So, this could be a reasonably good critical experience prototype. So, something which is related to the experience that a person would have when he envisions about this product or concept. Okay, the product here is really about improving the dentistry. So, something which will be giving you a first hand experience about dentistry in the first place, before even going to envision what is the need for a proper dental system or a proper dental management, okay, within the country. So that's called an experience prototype, okay. There can be a dark horse prototype, which means it may be a usually little known contender as a race horse that makes an unexpectedly good showing. It may not be altogether in the race at all. It is completely out of the box, that some idea props up which may replace the main product with something which is a much more useful appendage to the main product, which makes it sell. Okay, so this is an entrant in a context that is sort of judged unlikely to succeed, but if we explore the feasibility of such a dark horse prototype, it may turn out to be the innovative idea which may make a lot of difference in selling. If you remember, in our first lecture we were talking about the Swiffer, which was a PNG product, where we were talking about a mop and how, you know, just putting a stick to the end of this mop and then replacing or replacing the mop every time, making it into a use and throw cartridge and retaining the stick itself, proved out to be one of the most innovative ideas which upswung the or swung up the sales for PNG by almost 1000+ folds. So in that case, when we were looking up for a mop as the main product, somebody figured out that the mop is the most inconvenient part of the product, because it has to be washed and cleaned every time before the sweeping. And so why not make that product completely be a disposable unretained part of the product, whereas the stick which would be attached to it to be the retained part. The stick was never in purview before one thought like this to drive home the innovation. So this could be some kind of a dark horse prototype which may or may not work, but then there may be having an innovative idea which will make it sell. So that is how you kind of look into the various different kind of prototypes. So typically any prototyping would start with a sort of a deconstruction of the system, particularly in terms of functions. Can we map what are the various parts related to a product? For example, if I am looking at a bike like this, I should be able to get a frame, you know, which is composed of different parts which are added together. There is a handle part, there is also this the support member, okay, and then there are these wheels, there is a seat. So these are some of the parts that would come up to your mind the moment you start thinking of a bike. And so you have to somehow deconstruct the whole system into small subsystems, okay, whenever we think about prototyping of something. So for example, in a bike you could think of different components. For example, there could be a harness, there could be bearings, there could be some communication system which is made up of, again, servos or some display units or some protocols. Similarly, steering system, which could be made up of a bar, a steering fork, a steering axle, maybe a thrust bearing, okay, which which helps the easy maneuverability of related to the system. Then also there is a rider component for this bike, or even in fact there is also a sort of a, you can say, a wheel system which would be comprised of an axle or let's say an axial bearing. There could also be a pusher system. So in this manner you could kind of deconstruct whatever is there in a normal bike, okay, and try to maybe develop a prototype using a material which is not very conventional in biking. Maybe use just paper to build up such a bike. So this kind of, whenever there is a prototyping activity, deconstructing from whatever is existing and trying to do a functional mapping is very commonplace when we try to work or start working on prototypes. So I would like to sort of end this small module on prototyping here, with the hope that, you know, in the next module you would like to again look into a little more organized knowledge about how to bring in the design process through looking at the product architecture or product functionality or even the configuration aspects of a design. So for now, thank you very much and goodbye.